Welcome to Chat About Movies. I'm your host, Teagan. This is about chatting about movies that we may or may not like, what we think about them, and what we think might have gone better, or how we think of them as rebooted or impossible crossovers, or the possibility of seeing them in real life. So, buckle up and we'll see how we go. Last week we talked about how much we loved our movies. But this time we're going to ask what ones we don't like. So, our first caller, Aaron, would you like to tell us what movie you don't like?
I didn't like the Titanic because it went on for too long. It took 3 hours for the thing to sink. I know it's about history, but I just didn't like it. Didn't like that version. I don't like remakes of remakes because I find that the remake that they've made of originals are fine, but I don't like them because they're sort of based on the same thing. So, for example, you know how they've remade Aladdin? I haven't seen it, but I've heard it's quite good, but nothing beats the original. They remade Beauty and the Beast. The remake's not exactly my sort of cup of tea, but that's just my take on it. Other people can do their take on it. I don't like remakes of remakes because they're the same, but they're not. And I mean, I suppose this changes as good as a holiday, but in some cases, it's not.
Are there certain characters you don't like?
Not really. I mean, I like all characters, but, you know, I don't like the really spooky characters from spooky movies. I'm not into those. They're a bit odd looking and weird.
What wasn't your favorite one growing up?
I'm not actually sure on that one. I'm a bit cross between two. Actually, I didn't have I didn't really like the never ending story because I didn't really understand it.
Yeah. Well, that's interesting. So what would you rather think it'd be done differently?
But as I said, nothing is as good as the original. But I mean, I suppose if you were updating it, you wouldn't have stone creatures and flying dogs and a horse that drowns in quicksand and a whole lot of other stuff. You would have it more modernized, which I hate.
Okay, I think that's enough for now. So,
okay,
so how about we answer our next one? Carol, would you like to say anything? What are the movies that you don't like?
I think horror.
Any specifics?
No, just full-on horror. I don't like a lot of movies at the moment. I think I'm a bit fussy now. Bad acting. It's a bit of a turn-off. There's lots of TV programs I don't like either. Reality shows. I'm not big on reality shows.
What would you consider as the absolute worst, in your opinion?
Of the reality shows? Yeah, I would say, I think it's the dating genre ones, you know, the ones on, I think that's really weird to sort of air your whole dating life, your personal life, and do it for the world to see. Yeah, they're weird. Weird sort of people sharing stuff on TV to the world.
Is there any shows that you didn't like while you were growing up?
Well, I think because TV was new when I was growing up, I think the novelty of it, we all quite liked it. I'm showing my age now, Teagan.
Okay, so Ryan, would you like to answer some questions?
Yep, ready to go.
What movies don't like?
I don't like Mad Max so much. That's one of them, at least.
What is it that you don't like about it?
I think it's the whole idea that it was at first an outback setting and then it turns into a post-apocalypse with little or no explanation of just how it happens at all. Whether it's nuclear fallout or civilization going bonkers, you don't really see anything real that sort of tells you how or why it happened, but it just happened. And I don't like stories where there's no explanation of what happens a lot so much.
Do you consider that as the worst type of movie? Or is there another in your opinion?
The worst movie I know of would be Trolls 2.
I'm sorry?
Trolls 2. It's a international production that features little men in gremlin masks that don't have any special effect quality at all, running around and torturing people who cannot act. So there's a famous line, it's like, they're eating him and now they're going to eat me. Oh my god. It was introduced to me by a friend and I thought it was the literal worst production I had ever seen in my life. Nothing scary or even good about it. It was just downright horrible to watch. Bad production quality all around.
So was there any movies you didn't like while growing up?
I did not like Blade Runner, the first movie, while growing up, because maybe I had a little bit of trouble understanding everything that was supposed to happen. I had to watch it more than a few times to really kind of get a vague sense of anything that happens. And I was just getting more and more tired with each time that I rewound and pressed play. So that one's definitely up there.
Do you think they could have done that better?
Honestly, I don't think they could have done it better because I think to many people, it was done right, but there's always some out there that will never really see how it's intended to be seen. So I think I may just be one of those people that see things that aren't seen by the people who know it's good, and I don't really hold that against them. I do know that they think it's good, and I'm not trying to dispel their opinion or anything like that.
Well, that's interesting input. So, we'll stop there for now.
Sure. Thanks for having me.
Okay. David, would you like to be next?
Yep. Okay, ask away.
What movie would you consider as the worst, in your opinion?
All right. Pretty sure there's going to be like quite a few people that would either, quite a lot of people that might disagree with me. But I remember taking my cousins to see a movie which was many years ago, and it was actually one of the many original Pokemon movies that I saw. And I remembered going with my mum and my dad, and we sat through the very first Pokemon movie, and we all of a sudden we were all three of us, well, both my mum and dad and I, were absolutely bored to the extent that my mum fell asleep. My eyes were still fixated on the screen, trying to understand what Pokemon was and Pikachu and those sort of weird characters. And Dad said it was a bit like watching Question Time in Parliament. So I personally have to say that the Pokemon movie was boring. Not the one that has just come out now, but there was an original one in the 90s. So, or back in 2000s. I can't remember. But yeah, it was, I felt pretty bored.
Was there certain characters that you didn't like?
Pretty much all of them. Pretty much all of them, because I just didn't understand the whole story. I didn't understand the whole characters. Didn't quite understand or get what they were all about. So it's just like I remembered I was bored to tears. So, yeah.
Do you think there's any way it could be improved?
Not sure if any way it could be improved. Maybe if it was sort of like simplified, probably. Maybe even something like to say, okay, just explain what Pikachu is, explain what the whole scenario is. I sort of felt like, okay, what's quite going on? And the weird, and even more so weird, we were the only ones in the theatre, so that probably tells you about how much of how that show was, of how much that show was about. Yeah.
Okay, I think we're getting a little pressed for time, so we'll just need to talk with our last caller.
Cool.
Seb, would you like to finish?
Yep.
So, what movie did you not like?
Well, sometimes there's like very well-regarded movies that maybe you just see at the wrong time, or you just don't get into as much as everybody else seems to. One film that I wasn't that into was 2001: A Space Odyssey. Like at the time when I saw it, I just felt it was really slow and kind of boring, and it's meant to be like a classic masterpiece, and I like other Stanley Kubrick films, but 2001 like is one of those films that you're supposed to like, and I wasn't into it.
Do you think it could have been improved?
I don't know, actually. Probably not, because it was, you know, made how it was intended to be made, and most people consider it a masterpiece. So just because I found it a bit slow, I don't think it necessarily needs to be changed.
Were there certain characters you didn't like?
Not really. I don't know how much character development there really was, which might be part of why I wasn't that engaged.
What would you consider as the absolute worst movie?
Oh, that's a very hard question, because I quite like some bad movies. Like, you know, when movies are sort of considered terrible, but if you watch them, even though you know that they're bad, they're kind of hilarious and entertaining in their badness. But then, yeah, often the ones that you really don't like are just, they're more mediocre than terrible, because mediocre films are just like, there's nothing to really get into. Whereas terrible films I quite enjoy.
Were there any films you didn't like growing up?
Yeah, I didn't like horror films as a kid. And yeah, so anything that scared me, like I saw one of the Friday the 13th movies at a friend's birthday party once, and I had nightmares for weeks, so I hated that. But if I watch that film now, I probably wouldn't be scared by it because it's really, like, it hasn't aged well and it's, you know, bad special effects and it's just ridiculous and over the top.
Did you ever felt like you had a negative impact?
Yeah, I mean, it gave me nightmares for weeks, so yeah, I don't think I watched it at the right age.
So how would that describe you now?
Yeah, now I would probably find it really funny. Just because of the acting and the special effects and just how ridiculous it is. But as a child, I thought it was like very realistic and terrifying.
Okay, I think that's all we can do for now.
Excellent. Thanks for having me, Teagan.
And that's all we have for today. So see you next time. And that was Chat About Movies. I hope you all enjoyed that and gained some valuable insight. I'm Teagan, and this has been Echo Collective. I hope to see you next time.